But he did say that if he gets the bars back, he'll get them on as quickly as he can and get the bike back to me, or, well, like, go and pick it up. Let's talk about this bike for a minute. This bike is, you know, I guess it's a motorcycle. It has two wheels. This is a bike that I would really like for its intended purpose, which is literally, as the name suggests, to go across the country. I kid you not, this bike, if you're going to go from Massachusetts to California, this is the bike that you want to be on. There is nothing about this bike that's going to aggravate you over a long period of time, and the cargo capacity on this bike is pretty amazing. I mean, it's got this huge trunk in the back. It's got the biggest saddlebags. The cross-country, anyway, has just the biggest saddlebags I've ever seen on a bike. So it's an exceptionally inoffensive bike, except for the color, which... and of course the directionals that always cancel on you when you don't want them to. But it's just, you know, it's a bike that it does so many things well. It doesn't aggravate you. But here's the issue. All right, so number one, it takes away two of the things that I really like about motorcycling. I love the wind in my face and against my body. That's why I was kind of a little surprised that I ended up with a bike with a fairing, because it does kind of take some of that wind away. But it's not too bad on the Indian. And I love the sound. So that's why the Judge really worked very well for me. It had the little windshield, and it had a good sound, and I was pretty happy, but again, the longer trips were just a pain. So, this bike has neither wind nor sound. This windshield was, I think, taken off of a Chevy Chevette. It's huge. It's certainly the widest, the biggest windshield I've ever seen on a fared bagger. My friend Sally has a windshield that's probably bigger than this, but doesn't have the fairing with it. It's tall, and I'm looking like right through it. This guy's probably wondering, like, why are you pointing to me? Stop pointing at me. And the sound, I mean, my gosh, it's just nothing. You hear the engine so much more than you hear the exhaust. And even when I've ridden in front of Sally, you know, I'll like get on the throttle, and she's like, nothing. So I do feel a little bit invisible when I ride this. Number one, because I'm riding something that is the color of freshly pooped on pavement. And number two, nobody can hear me. So it is kind of a strange thing. But there are some huge pluses to this bike. This seat is extremely comfortable, right up there with the Indian. Very, very comfortable for me. This is the cross-country tour seat. So it's not the seat that you get on the regular cross-country. It comes on the tour only. Although my dealer has always said if I bought a cross-country, they could swap out the seat, no big deal. So the seat is fantastic. The floorboards, as with every cross-country, are just huge. I mean, you can put your feet, like, anywhere you want. You know, back here, you can put them up here, you know, over here, wherever you want to put them. It's fine. For a short guy, the foot controls are a little bit stretched out, but you get used to it actually very quickly. This is actually the third cross-country that I've ridden. I have two videos that maybe I'll release at some point. I just never really thought it'd be very interesting. One was my very first test ride on a cross-country last year, and then the second was I had rented a cross-country for a weekend. Again, not the tour, but just the regular cross-country. And that one was a Nuclear Sunset Orange, and you know, that's an interesting feeling going down the road on something that color. I never quite figured out how I felt. There were days I thought, you know, this is so different, I actually love it. And then there were days that I thought, I'm riding what? It was weird. But anyway, this bike just does so many things well. It just corners beautifully for such a big bike. I mean, it's like anything you want it to do, it just does. It doesn't have the torque of the Indian, but then what does, really? Again, very inoffensive. The radio on this particular unit is broken. Apparently this was in an accident last year. This is what I'm getting from the dealer. They're still finishing up just some of the minor details. Like, for example, there are no badges on the tank. They probably resprayed the tank. I'm not sure. I don't know the nature of the accident or anything like that or how bad it was. But one of the things that does not work is the radio. What you can do is you can put your iPod on or in there. It goes into this little compartment down here, and it will play, because right now, as you can see here, maybe, it is in auxiliary mode, so it's going to take sound from the auxiliary input, which is the iPod. So if I stick my iPod in there, it will just play in the order, you know, whatever order is on the iPod, and it will play at a constant volume, because the volume doesn't work. So you can adjust the volume, you can adjust the song that you're listening to. So if I hadn't taken it off in the last couple of months, there's a very good chance that I could be going down the road listening to, you know, Do You Want to Build a Snowman? Let me just navigate this little puddle of death here. And I say that only because there's so much gravel underneath there. Okay. I'll tell the snowman story at some point. But anyway. This is me. Now, I am renting this. The Harley that my buddy let me loan, I just felt like after a week, you know, I mean, we talked about, okay, yeah, you can have it for a week. And after a week, I just felt like, number one, a week is long enough to borrow a bike from somebody. And number two, I wasn't riding it as often as I would have thought, just because I don't want to go into all the issues. It's a very nice looking bike, and I can see why somebody... No, I can't. Anyway, so that notwithstanding, I brought the Harley back, and I realized that I still had 2 weeks left before I was going to get my bike back. So I went to my local dealership, which is Mom's South in Foxborough, and they were fantastic. You know, I've bought so many bikes there. I got this rental... I mean, don't expect to get this. I think this is kind of an unusual deal because, number one, the time of year. Number two, the fact that this was still being sort of reconstructed after its accident, I guess. Although it rides fine. I mean, there's no issues mechanically with it. And I don't even really see any issues with it cosmetically. So there's that. And then there's also just the fact that I have spent so much money there over the years. And so I think they were just really nice. They understood the sort of predicament that I was in. This is fantastic. Well, okay, this is not fantastic riding weather, but normally at the end of May, I mean, at the end of April and the beginning of May, it is fantastic riding weather. So I just felt horrible not being able to ride. And so I told them, I said, look, I can't spend the normal price on these things. I just can't justify that for 2 weeks. So they gave me this for 14 days for less than the price of 4 days rental. And that's pretty awesome. So a big shout out to Mom South for that. Truly appreciated. And so this is what I'm riding for another week and a half or so. So, and I'm not complaining. It's a nice bike. It's a nice bike. So anyway, I will talk to you guys soon. And thanks again for all the comments on the Chieftain reveal video. It's been fun talking to you guys and just kind of going through this process. This is what I got into vlogging for, and it's been fun. So, all right, talk to you guys later. Me and my quiet little bike here. The Victory Cross Country Tour, where the valves make more noise than the exhaust.